Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was the youngest man sallallahu alaihi wasallam that stood on the day of al-Hilf al-Fudul, the day of the League of the Virtuous, when they came together to establish the economic rights of each and every single member of that society. Ironically, subhanAllah, that came about because a foreigner came to Mecca and he was wrong, and he wrote a long poem about how the people of Mecca think that they're absolved, how they think that because the Kaaba is in their possession, or they think it's in their possession, how the Kaaba is amongst them, they can wrong people. And you know what, when you go to Mecca today, what do you see outside of those big buildings? What do you see behind that clock tower? What do you see only a few feet away from the cloth of the Kaaba, which costs millions and millions of dollars to manufacture every single year? What do you see? You see mutilated people that are begging to live. Mutilated people that can't eat and drink. That's not our Islam. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he was asked to change the cloth of the Kaaba, he said, the poor people are more worthy of being clothed and being fed than the Kaaba. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, مَا أَطْهَرُكِ, how pure are you, مَا أَعْظَمُكِ, how great are you, but I swear that the ard, the honor, the blood, the property of a believer is more sacred to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than you. That's not our Islam. Our Islam doesn't neglect the things around us and just worry about the rituals. The Kaaba at the time of the Prophet ﷺ was not this amazing, beautiful structure. The masjid of the Prophet ﷺ was not beautiful because of all the mist and all of the fans and the, you know, the roofs that retract. The masjid of the Prophet ﷺ didn't even have a roof. The masjid of the Prophet ﷺ didn't even have a carpet. They prayed on dirt. That wasn't what made the masjid special, and it wasn't what made the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam special. Before Islam, he was a social activist. The youngest man, what does that tell you about him? He was far beyond his peers. In his 20s, the Prophet ﷺ was standing with the elders of his tribe, putting his hand on the Kaaba and ensuring that the rights of people would be respected. And the Prophet ﷺ said, if I was called to that again after Islam, I would join it, even with people of shirk. Even with people of polytheism, I would join them to ensure the rights of people. The Prophet ﷺ was not a pacifist. Rasulullah ﷺ spoke up. The Prophet ﷺ was an activist. He was a sadiq al-amin. He was a man that was trusted. He cared about the dunya of people. And that's why when he stood up ﷺ to call people to goodness in the akhirah, they trusted him. Those that believed in him, trusted him. Because they knew that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a man that tried to rectify their affairs in this world. So surely he was trying to rectify their affairs in the hereafter as well. This was the Islam of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam.